Hello, Jim Guthrie here. I want to show a little bit about knife skills. You ever seen a chef go in and they can be talking and you watch them cutting something like that and you wonder, how do they not cut their finger along the way? I'd like to teach you something you can practice at home that'd be really, really helpful. You need a flat palette knife. There's no edge to this. It's often used for spreading frosting on a cake. They come in different sizes. You can find them at the kitchen store. You want to use this as your practice knife. You can sit in front of the television and watching your favorite program. And you can sit there, and what I first encourage you to do is learn to pull your fingers back. That's really important. As if you're holding food, you're pulling your fingers back, and always the only thing you want here is from knuckle to knuckle showing with your fingertips underneath. It's very, very important. And what you do is you sit in front of the television and you begin to do this. Cut, 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 moving your fingers back. Never moving the fingers out like this as though you're going to cut them. That's very, very important. Keep your fingers back here from knuckle to knuckle. And you begin going very slowly and then you speed up. And here's what's going to happen. You speed up and ouch, ouch. Better to do it with this knife than with this knife, right? This is where you practice. You learn until you no longer go above the knuckle. It's the same thing cutting it this way. You learn to practice with this knife until such time that you don't go up so high. It's very important. You can sit and practice. Take you 2 to 3 days practice before you go like this. After doing this for a while, then you get to take the real chef's knife. I'm going to take some asparagus spears. I'm going to do this, and notice right here, I'm just going to keep my fingers going. And I'm not even looking, I'm looking at you. I'm able to chop through. I am using my knuckle as the guide. I want that metal always right across the knuckle here. That allows me to keep talking and chopping without having to worry. And all the while, my tips are underneath here. And I'm gradually working my way back. That's how you should be cutting in your kitchen.